this problem, right? Whether all of you are hearing? Yes. So today we will see, good morning to all of you. We will see this problem today. Actually, we have a simply supported beam subject to a point load, 6 kN, and a UDL, 2 kN per meter, spread over a length of 3 meter, that to near right support, right? Now, what is asked in this problem? A beam AB of 6 meter span is simply supported at the ends and is loaded as shown in figure. Determine deflection at C, maximum deflection, and slope at end A. I think this problem we have seen last class, right? This problem is over. We have seen it in the last class. Okay, most of you don't remember because I told you very fastly. Most of you don't remember, I think. This problem we have seen. The last class, I told you this problem, I think. Okay, we have seen it, right? So let us see whether we have any other good problem in these notes. Yeah, problems are plenty. We can keep on doing. If you see it, you will understand. Okay, I need not discuss every time. Right? I hope you will understand this kind of problem all. Okay, if I take some big problem, yeah, there are plenty of problems. Other, we have an overhanging beam. Let us see. We'll see this. An overhanging beam ABC supported at A and B is loaded as shown in figure. Determine the deflection at the free end and the maximum deflection between A and B. Take I equal to 600 centimeter power 4 and E is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per mm square. Okay. So we are going to do it by Michaelis method. So I am just, let us see this problem, right? Here we have a overhanging beam, right side, there is a overhanging portion, 2 meter overhanging, this beam is overhanging. Okay, at the free end of this overhanging, the 4 kN point load is acting. Somewhere between the support A and B, there is a UDL, okay? Spread over a length of 2 meter is acting. It is spread over a length of 2 meter. Okay, of 3 kN per meter density is acting. Let us see how to deal with this kind of problem. Okay, so problems are plenty. I advise you because concept I already have conveyed it to you, already have taught you. It is your duty to get familiarity. There are several problems you have to work out. Certain problems are lengthy also. Okay, time consuming. So you have to get familiarity. Many competitive exam like engineering services exam, GATE exam, even civil services exam. When you write a descriptive paper, this kind of questions are being asked, big problems, okay, deflections of, especially that certain books like, why those who prepare for competitive exam, normally they used to refer textbooks like Vajran Rathwani and all. The reason was, in that book, especially if you take any Kanna publishes book, like a structural analysis by Vajran Rathwani, in that he has discussed the mechanics of solids, mechanics of material, structural analysis, all together. Okay. They're almost one and the same, nothing different. The beginning is mechanics of solids or mechanics of materials or strength of materials. The continuity is structural analysis when you go further, very deep into the structures. Okay, framework. That's what. That book, Vajran Rathwani, has given many questions which were asked in GATE exam, IES exam, civil services exam. Such questions have been solved in such textbooks. That is why many reputed institute, those who prepare especially for competitive exam, they refer such a book. But the only disadvantage with that book is a lot of printing mistakes in that OP Kanna publications. Okay, that is why it has not got popularity, but it is popular among those who prepare for a competitive exam. Okay, once last class I told you, if you have to future, you have to appear for an entrance test, okay, when you apply for job to public sector like Indian Oil Corporation, SAIL, okay, NTPC and all. Now that was the case earlier. But what happened, many people appeared in that exam. What was going on, we don't know. Many meritorious students could not get through, were not selected. That there was a allegation came. Actually, these public sectors favoring their own employees, wards like that, there was allegations. Okay, that is why now the GATE has been made compulsory. If you want to apply for a job, to a good job, executive position in the future in public sectors, companies, what to do? You must be qualified in GATE. You have to get through GATE examination. Okay, that has been, instead of those entrance exam, their own entrance exam, everybody has switched over to gate exam. The government has made it, MHRD has made it compulsory. If you have gate score, that is valid for 5 years. Using that, you can apply for a job in public sector companies. Okay, and that is the trend today. Few years back, it was made that way. Okay, when I was completed my graduation, that was every public sector used to conduct their own entrance exam. But now, gate is must. When you appear gate, this kind of big questions you will be having in the descriptive. Okay, so you have to get familiarity if you want to come up in life. If you want to get good job, out of your interest, you have to learn. You should not try to learn in examination point of view. By enjoying the subject, you have to learn it. Okay, then only definitely you will be identified. If you have knowledge, very strong academic knowledge in that your course of study, or if you have very good academic record, definitely you will be identified somewhere and you will be absorbed. That is why hopefully you can read, you can work hard, right? That is my advice and suggestion and so on to you people, right? Now we have a overhanging beam like this. There is a point load acting. Okay, let us see how to solve such problems. So what the author has, what has been done, the superposition technique have been followed. Okay, even without following superposition technique also you can do. But the problem is, in the previous problem, I will go to this. Where the point load act, okay, this kind of problem, right? So for example, this, the UDL is up to the end, right? So what happened, the beam is divided into several portion. If you take origin A and consider a section in between AD and DC and CD, okay, you have to go to the far away portion, right? From origin, if you take A, the far away portion is CD. In that portion, what is the general expression for bending moment? This is a reaction into x, and then this load into the distance, okay, between the section and this load, and then this portion of the UDL, part of the UDL, which is lying left side of the section. Okay, all these things you are writing expression for bending moment. Okay, if you for this portion, the first term, the first part of the equation is applicable. If you go to the portion DC, the sine part of the equation is applicable. First and second, two terms are applicable. Okay, you have to consider these two terms. If you go to the last portion, all the three terms you have to consider. Okay, all the entire equation you have to consider. Okay, so that way we can write a general expression. Okay, but here in this problem, what happened? It will change, right? In this problem, for portion AD or D, if you take far away portion from A, suppose you choose A as origin, you choose far away portion BC. If you write a section XS and try to write a general expression for bending moment, we cannot bring as we brought earlier, okay, the terms. That is why some modification required to be done. That's why it's Michaelis method. Okay, in Michaelis method, we do certain procedure, certain special manner we do things, okay. As usual, you cannot write a general expression for bending moment, as usual, you can't write. You have to write it in a special manner. How do you write it? See, here, instead of this UDL, what we consider, if you want to choose A as origin, the UDL should go up to the end, either the right end of the beam or left end of the beam, somewhere, okay? That is why here the UDL is considered fully downward. And then, this side, no UDL, no in the beam. So, this portion, UDL, we have to deduct. That's why there is the upward UDL is shown here, up to this end. Upward UDL is shown here up to this end. So this get cancelled, no? Downward, upward, get cancelled. So no UDL here. Only this portion of the UDL is there. So the beam loaded this way is equal to or equivalent to this beam, right? The beam loaded like this is equal to or equivalent to this beam, right? So this way we have to deal things in order to write a general expression here, which is applicable for all the portion. Not entire equation, the part of the equation. First term, second term, third term of the equation applicable for the other portions. Likewise, you have to write. For that purpose, we do this special manner. Right? Let us see how it has been written. The first step is the determination of support reaction. Support reaction you can determine by investigating this load diagram, no problem. Okay, so support, so the reaction at the support RA is required. So RA into 5, okay. how much this one? 2 2 plus 2 4 plus 1 5. Ra into 5 minus is okay minus this one 3. 3 into 2 into because the moment is taking moment about B, right? 3 into 2 into 3. Okay, 3 into 2 into 3. Next one, that's all. Moment this side. And other one, okay. Not only moment this side. See here, if you take moment about a B, RA produces clockwise moment. You can write it with 90 sign, no problem. If you take moment about B, RA produces clockwise moment, no? Minus RA into 5. Plus, because this 3 kN produces anticlockwise moment here. Plus 3 into 2 into 3. Okay. Then this 4 kN produces again clockwise moment. So minus 4 into 2 is equal to 0. From this RA is equal to 1 by 5 into 3 into 2 into 3 minus 4 into 2. Therefore, RA is equal to 2 kN upward. So that support reaction at RA has been determined. Okay. Please you apply your mind because you are very familiar in determining support reaction. I need not teach you again and again. Already you have studied in earlier two subjects, engineering mechanics and mechanics of solids. You have studied very thoroughly the determination of support reactions. You all are very thorough. So this way you have to determine support reaction. In this problem, similarly, support reaction at RB also determined. You know how to determine support reaction at RB. Either you can use sigma FO equal to 0 or taking again moment about A. RB has been determined this way. Okay, I don't want to teach you that again, once again that how to determine support reaction. Okay, straight away I'll go to this. Now we are writing the general expression for bending moment, right? So you take origin A, go to the far away portion, which is BC. Consider a section XX and write a general expression for bending moment, which is equal to, that is EA du square y by dx square equal to minus M. I will come to that. First time I will tell you here MX, M suffix X, where in the far away portion from A, I am choosing A as the origin. From A, I take the far away portion of the beam, which is BC. Here I am considering a section, right, at a distance X from A. Now I am writing general expression for bending moment. What is that? Here the support reaction is found to be 2, no? So this beam, we have to consider this beam. 2 into, please all of you listen, okay, this is upward moment, so positive for us. Okay, Mx equal to 2 into X, the section is here, at a distance X from A. 2 into X, okay, minus, all of you listen very carefully, minus this UDL, okay, minus 3 into X minus 1 into X minus 1 divided by 2. So 3 into X minus 1 whole square divided by 2. Okay, that one. Next, the moment here is due to the upward UDL. Due to the upward UDL, positive bending moment plus 3 into X minus 3. Okay, because the UDL starts from here 3, right? X minus 3 into X minus 3 divided by 2. That is 3 into X minus 3 whole square divided by 2. Okay. This way we are getting expression for bending moment. Okay. So this is written here. Therefore, EA d square y by dx square equal to minus MX is equal to that plus 2X becomes minus 2X dotted line plus 3 into X minus 1 whole square divided by 2 dotted lines minus 3 into X minus 3 whole square divided by 2 dotted lines. Okay, minus, I'm sorry, I forgot to take this support reaction here. Just now I told you the general expression. Yeah, Dhanara, okay. Just now I told you how to write general expression for bending moment in this portion. Okay, that time I forgotten to take into account the reaction at B. Okay, please include that also. What is this also upward? So in our MX equation, RB is 8. 8 into X minus 5. Okay, so when you write EA d square by dx square equal to minus MX, this become minus here, minus 8 into X minus 5. Okay, I'm sorry, when you write the general expression, I forgotten to inform you this support reaction here. Okay, so if you consider a section XX, bending moment due to all the portion at the left side of the section should be taken into account. Okay, bending moment due to all the forces at the left side of the section should be taken into account when you consider a section XX here. Okay, this way the general expression has been written in a special manner. It has been written. The given beam also modified in a special manner, like this. Okay, the given load this way. Please remember, the UDL is acting somewhere in a portion of the beam. Now, what to do? The UDL should be taken either left end or up to the right end. Accordingly, here also. Okay, this way you have to modify the loading, which is in equivalent interaction with this one, the given beam. Okay, so this way we have done it. Now I am carrying out integration. Therefore, EA dy by dx is, dx is equal to minus 2x square by 2. So you know very well. So integral constant should be included in the first term. I told you already the Michaelis method plus C1. This way the integration has been carried out. Integration also carried out in a special manner, as I told you. When you want to integrate this x minus 1 whole square, you have to take that x minus 1 as a single variable. Okay, single variable term. That's why x minus 1 whole cube divided by 3 into 2, 6. Okay, this way in a special manner, we have carried out integration in the Michaelis method. Okay, next integrating again, EAy is equal to x cube by 3. Okay, because this becomes x cube by 3, 2 get cancelled. So x cube by 3 plus c1x plus c2. So integral constant we are including in the first term, remember. And then we are carrying out in a special manner the integration of the other terms, okay, which is already I told you, you are aware of it, right? So it has been written like this. This way we have carried out the integration. Now we have to evaluate this integral constant by applying boundary condition, okay? What is meant by boundary condition? We know the values of slope and deflection at some salient points, especially at supports, okay? At x is equal to 0, it means at support A, y is 0, the deflection is 0, we know that value. Now you apply this in this equation, so hence C2, the integral constant 2 becomes 0, okay? Similarly, at x is equal to 5 meter, at support B, at x is equal to 5 meter means support B, again the deflection is equal to 0, this value is known to us, okay? Hence, from equation 2, including appropriate terms, okay, now apply x is equal to 5 here and y equal to 0 here. So if you write down, the integral constant C1 is found to be 2.3333. Okay. Hence, the slope equation is written and the slope and deflection equations are written including the integral constant C1. Okay. C1 including the value of for C1 value. The once again, the slope equation and deflection equation have been written. Okay. Now it is with us. Using them, we can determine the deflection and slope at any required points, right? So, deflection at C. Now, the problem it is asked, you have to determine deflection at C. Where is that point C? It is at the free end here. So, you have to determine deflection at C. To determine the deflection at C, you have to consider, because the deflection C is, the point C is in the portion, last portion. That's why you have to consider all the terms, all the three terms, okay? Entire equation you have to take into account. In that you have to substitute x is equal to 7 meter. Okay, x is measured from A. So at C, the x value is 7 meter. Substitute in the entire equation for deflection. Okay, if you substitute, y at C is found to be 1.78 mm. Please, all of you remember, don't think it is just like that we are doing something. Even if you fabricate a beam like this in the laboratory, and apply this load as shown in this problem. If you keep your dial cage at the free end of the beam and measure, your experimental value will exactly tally with this theoretical value. Okay, experimental also it can be proved. Although we have done a lot of approximation in our computation, assumption and approximation, the solution obtained will be very close to the exact values. Okay, if you do experimentally also, you will be getting the same deflection at the free end of the beam. That you remember, it has been proved in the laboratory, right? Many institutions such experiments are also available, right? Already I told you. I can tell you, okay. Next one, for maximum deflection. Now you have to determine maximum deflection. It is obvious that the maximum deflection will occur somewhere between A and B. That is very clear from this problem, okay? So the deflection is going to be maximum somewhere between A and B. Let us see. So, what we do, if you want to get the maximum deflection, what to do? We know at the maximum deflection point, the slope is 0. So where the slope is zero, at maximum deflection point, the slope will be zero. That is, dy by dx will be zero. So you have to equate the dy by dx equation to zero. But how many terms you have to consider this equation? Because the slope, you have to write slope equation to zero for the portion AB only. Okay, for the portion AB, na only how many terms? First two terms. Why first two terms? Right? First two terms or all the terms for this portion? Yeah, that is the thing. Except this support reaction. When you consider a section here, all this load will come into account. Except this RB, no? That is why, except that RB, last term, you have to consider other terms, okay? Except the last term. That's why, don't take into account the last term, only the remaining terms equal to zero. Because dy by dx is zero, slope is zero, okay? So here, except the last term, other terms equal to zero. From this, we are getting a cubic equation or quadratic equation. I think you are getting here, seems to be cubic equation. You are getting a cubic equation. See how lengthy kind of a problem we get. Finally, by solving by trial and error method, because it's a cubic equation, it's not a quadratic equation. By trial and error method solving it, the x is found to be 1.555 meter. Okay. Now, substituting, we are getting this. I come to some other problem. Yeah. Where is that? Yeah, here. So continuity is here. Okay. So substituting, you are getting y max equal to 1.37 mm. Positive value you are getting. It means the deflection is downward. Okay. As per our derivation. So 1.37 mm, very minute deflection. See, the problem looks like simple, right? The problem looks like a very simple beam. But you see the amount of computation involved, the calculation involved. Okay. Although the beam look like a very simple problem, how much we have to work out, see, we are getting a cubic equation, you have to solve that cubic equation, right? So it will, they are slightly time consuming. That is why when we were student, a subject like a structural analysis, this kind of some mechanics of solids too, or mechanics of materials, we used to be very, how to say, nervous because of time. Time is precise, even for structural design, steel design and all, everywhere, time consuming. Okay, within that given 3 hours, we have to solve all the five big problems and small questions and all. So we used to be very, you have to be speedy, right, during exam. You have to be very speedy in your computation. Both the speed and accurate, both are important, but accuracy is more important than speed, that you remember. But you have to, for that, more practice required. When I was a student, I used to go with tension for especially subject like mechanics of materials, structural analysis, structural design, RCC, structural design, steel. I used to worry a lot. The reason was time management. Okay, within the 3 hours, we have to solve all the problem and we have to do all the computation which are time consuming. Okay, so for that, more practice required to do it that way. But you nowadays, you people are, I feel for you people, right? You are living in all this electronic media, a lot of distraction. You people are, majority of you are not at all concentrating on studies, not serious about your studies, because there's a distraction available. You are spending most of your times in your cell phone. Okay, the young generation is like that. What to do? When we were a student, that time no such electronic media. Some TV was there, that too we used to see. Okay, so in this online class, I don't want to talk all this story as you used to talk in the class, right? But I feel for it, right? So with this, but please spend some time to read and work hard, okay? So all the time you should not spend in electronic media like cell phone and social media and watching so many unwanted programs and all. Sometime your valuable time is spare for your betterment, for your studies, for your future. Out of your self-interest, you have to learn this kind of subject. Okay, it is easy for me to project and tell. Already I conveyed you the concept of the subject, but it is your duty to get a familiarity. See, I just discussed this, right? Now please, all of you see here, Now I am for your understanding purpose, since I don't have notes, it's not notes. Notes so far I used to teach only in the classroom. Please see here. It is your duty to take some exercise problem and work out. Take some problem from the exercise. First, to go through the worked examples of the any textbook which you refer. After referring and understanding clearly, take the same problem and do it in your own and compare whether you are arriving at the correct answer or not. Right? Then you take some exercise problem and work out in your own and compare your answer with the answer provided in the exercise. Thus, you have to ascertain. This way, you have to ascertain your level of understanding and your capability of solving such a problem. Okay. So, engineering course is not an easygoing course. You have to work hard. We have to come up like that only. Nobody has done spoon feeding for us. Okay. Out of our hard work, we have learned everything. That you keep it in mind. Again, I am telling such advice. Right. Next, okay. Likewise, we can keep on solving so many problems. It is your duty because the Michaelis method. Okay, I will do one thing. I will project the other textbook also to you. Suppose somebody refer Bavikatti, say, not Bavikatti. This book is Punmiya, Dr. B.C. Punmiya, I have told you. Suppose you are referring this book, Bansal, okay, which also a good book, right? Suppose you are referring Bansal, say, we will take some problem, right? We will see some problem here. Actually, Bansal, he adopted a different sign convention. What different sign convention, what he has done? Let us see some problem, right? We will take some problem. Where is that? What is it? Reflection of simply supported beams with a uniform distributed load. Okay, we will take some problem, right? Okay, this is the UDL, sorry, only one point load. This kind of problem already we have seen in that book. Let us go to some bigger problem. Same problem, similar problem. Okay, in BC Punmiya, we have seen this kind of problem. Here also, we have a simply supported beam substituted to point load, 40 kilonewton, 40 kilonewton, like this, right? So, what is the difference between this book and that book? Okay, suppose you people will be referring different textbook. Somebody may be comfortable with the Bansal. Okay, when you refer it, please remember the author has derived that equation, differential equation for deflection profile of the beam. He has taken different sign convention. That is why he is getting EA d square over dS equal to plus M. Okay, he adopted like that. So he determined the support reaction RB for this beam and then he equated straight away the expression MX to EA d square over dS square. He has not written EA d square by dx square equal to minus m. He has used a plus m. You can see in some of his previous problem that, no problem. Whether it is available this side, somebody might have given. Okay, it's not, it's not maybe previous, okay, refer the previous problem of this notes, right? This book textbook, right? So here he has equated. Finally, he has carried out the integration and all as I told you. The only difference between this Bansal and Punmiya is the sign convention. Okay. In Punmiya, as I told you, the sign convention EI d square over dx square equal to minus mx, minus m. Okay. But here he has adopted plus m because RA into x. See, the bending moment equation, he has written only mx here, not minus mx here. Okay. So he has carried out. Finally, after applying boundary condition and all, he got the deflection value, right? He has got the deflection value, which is found to be, where is that? Yeah, here. He's getting negative sign, right? He's getting negative sign in his answer. Minus 9.019 mm answer. Negative sign shows that deflection is downwards. Okay, so for downward deflection, in this book, negative sign comes. But in BC Punmiya, we are writing EI d square y by ds square equal to minus m, right? So first we are writing mx and then substituting it with the minus m. That is why whatever deflection you are getting, you will be getting plus sign, provided if the deflection is downward. If the beam deflects downward direction, you will be getting positive sign for the deflection because you are writing EI d square y by ds square equal to minus m. But in this textbook, the author has adopted a sign convention. EI d square y by dx square equal to plus m. So he is substituting. Finally, he is getting a downward deflection for which he is getting negative sign. Okay, that is the only difference, because he derived the differential equation for the profile of the beam for taking upward deflection positive. Okay, that is why that difference comes. That is upward curvature, right? What we have considered a cantilever beam downward curvature. This way, when you refer different textbooks, you should understand, right? What is the difference? The sign convention adopted. It may slightly vary from author to author. You should not get confused with the sign convention adopted, the notation used. In all, you should not get confused when you refer different textbooks. For example, there are plenty of good textbooks available in the market, isn't it? This PC Punmiya, Mechanics of Materials by VC Punmiya, Strength of Materials by Bansal. There are other textbooks, Ratan. There's a Strength of Materials by Ratan is there. What is that another one? Bavikit is there. When you refer, you should not get confused with the notations, different notations they might have adopted, different sign convention they might have used, but the concept will be the same. Concept will not change, right? So, because you are doing a professional course, accordingly, you have to refer and do it. Let us see any other problem can we see in this textbooks. Today, actually, I thought of starting the next method called a moment area method, right? Problems are plenty like that, right? Moment area, here also he has done a problem like this. See, in this problem itself he has given that way. Where is that? Yeah, this problem. Just now we have seen one problem, no? Similar problem. So, just now we have seen one problem. In that, the UDL was in the middle. Here the UDL is nearer to support B and a point load at the free end. Similar kind of problem is solved, right? Just now we have discussed almost similar kind of problem. See, this way the UDLs are modified, okay? Either the left up to the left end or up to the right end, the UDL, you have to take the UDL in order to write the general expression for bending moment by Michaelis method. This is very important. Everything we do in a special manner that you remember, right? So what else? I will do one thing. Is the couple? Let us go through. That is simple. Only the everywhere you know how to write a MX equation if any couple acts. In this book he has referred what is that? Cantilever beam separately. More first simply supported beam, and the definition of cantilever beam he has given a heading, and he has the author has discussed it separately. I think okay, cantilever beam overhanging beam, and then followed by. The author has this are overhanging beam, right? The author has adopted cantilever beam separately, a separate chapter. No problem. Cantilever beam already have discussed. Okay, this much only a teacher can teach because there are other methods I have to discuss with you. How to determine deflection of beam by double induction method is over. Michaelis method is over. Next, moment area method. Then conjugate beam method. Unit load method, and then deflection of trusses, and all I have to discuss with you. Okay, this much is sufficient. Meanwhile, just a few minutes. Meanwhile, I just want to take attendance. I want to move your names for our attendance record purpose. Today, 57 of you are attending the class, right? Few minutes, just for attendance purpose. I will scroll your names, right? Right, few minutes, just for okay. I advise you to refer any textbook on Orchard. Double integration method, whatever I have discussed with you, more than sufficient. Okay, but just listening to me, you can't learn. You have to please. You have to do the problem. Take some problem and work out and do it, right? Take some problem, work out and do it. Then only you will understand. I want to start the next method, moment area method. I will start it in the next class. Okay, I will discuss with you the next class. The another method, right? I will first stop recording. Then we will discuss anything if you want to discuss. We can discuss it, right? First, let me to stop recording. Today's class is over. It's much sufficient because I want to start the next method that I will discuss with you in the next class, right? So I will stop recording. Right.